I'm Jamie Billings from the College of Lake County, and I'm reading Nickel and Dime.
Hi, my name is Michelle Proctor, and I am an elementary education professor at the College of Lake County. And I will be reading From the Color Purple by Alice Walker.
My name is Jackie Hoy. I'm a student at the College of Lake County. I'm going to read Adventures of Huckleberry Finn by Mark Twain.
Hi, my name is Anna McCormick, and I'm reading Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets by J.K. Rowling.
My name is Michelle Slack. I'm a student at College of Lake County, and I'm reading George Orwell's Animal Farm.
Hi, my name is Danielle Robinson. I'm a student at College of Lake County in Grays Lake, Illinois. I'll be reading a passage from New Moon.
Hi, I'm Alyssa.
And I'm Courtney.
And we're students from CLC, and we'll be reading a passage out of The Catcher in the Rye.
Hello, my name is Bobby Smith. I'm a student at College of Lake County, and I'm reading The Fountainhead by Ayn Rand.
Hi, my name is Eddie. I'm a student at the College of Lake County, and I'm reading The Grapes of Wrath by John Steinbeck.
Hi, my name is Jacqueline Diaferro. I'm a student at College of Lake County, and I am going to be reading The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald.
Hi, my name is Janelle Rollis. I'm a student at CLC, and I'm reading Mockingjay by Susan Collins.
Hi, my name is Samantha.
My name is Samantha,
and we're from College of Lake County.
I'll be reading From The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald.
Hello, my name is Louis Ortiz, and I'm a student at CLC.
I'm Jamie McGarra. I'm also a student at CLC. We're going to be reading a passage from The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins.
Hi, I'm Michelle Carter, librarian at CLC, and today I'll be reading a piece from The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins.
Hi, my name is Kelly, and I'm reading The Catcher in the Rye by J.D. Salinger. If you really want to hear about it, the first thing you'll probably want to know is where I was born and what my lousy childhood was like and how my parents were occupied and all before they had me and all that David Copperfield kind of crap. But I don't feel like going into it. If you want to know the truth, in the first place, that stuff bores me. And in the second place, my parents would have about 2 hemorrhages apiece if I told anything personal about them.
When I came home to West 8 that night, I was afraid for a moment that my house was on fire. 2 o'clock and the whole corner of the peninsula was blazing with light, which fell unreal on the shrubbery and made thin, elongating glints upon the roadside wires. Turning a corner, I saw that it was Gatsby House, lit from tower to cellar. At first, I thought it was another party, a wild rout that had resolved itself into a hide-and-go-seek, or sardines in the box, with all the house thrown open to the game. But there wasn't a sound, only wind in the trees, which blew the wires and made the lights go off and on again, as if the house had winked into the darkness. As my taxi groaned away, I saw Gatsby walking toward me across his lawn.
It was all very careless and confused. They were careless people, Tom and Daisy. They smashed up things and creatures, and then retreated back into their money, or their vast carelessness, or whatever it was that kept them together, and let other people clean up the messes they had made.
I shook hands with him. It seemed silly not to, for I felt suddenly as though I were talking to a child. Then he went into the jewelry store to buy a pearl necklace, or perhaps only a pair of cuff buttons, rid of the provincial skirmishness forever.
He left feeling that if he had searched harder, he might have found her, that he was leaving her behind. The day coach, he was penniless now, was hot. He went out to the open vestibule and sat down on a folding chair, and the station slid away and the backs of unfamiliar buildings moved by. Then out into the spring fields where a yellow trolley raced them for a minute with people in it who might once have seen the magic pale of her face along the Catherine Street. The track curved and now it was going away from the sun, which as it sank lower seemed to spread itself in benediction over the vanishing city where she had drawn her breath. He stretched out his hand desperately, as if to snatch only a wisp of air, to save a fragment of the spot that she had made lovely for him. But it was all going by too fast now for his blurred eyes, and he knew that he had lost that part of it, the freshest and the best forever.